this is an example of a menu-driven program. So we're going to give the user some choices, display a menu, and let them select off the menu. So I'll scroll down and we'll look at the menu section. It's just going to print a title. And the idea is if they select one, we'll let them calculate the area of a circle, two for a rectangle, three for a triangle. If they enter four, they'll exit. And so if we scroll back up, that's at the bottom of this loop here. And so while menu choice is not equal to 4, in other words, it's not time to exit, we'll just keep redisplaying that menu and let the user run it as many times as they want. We'll initialize menu choice to 0. That'll make sure we get in the first time. Then we have this switch statement here for menu choice. And we have each case. So case 0 is just going to redisplay the menu. So we'll just break there. Case 1, we'll have them enter the radius. Calculate the area and then do the output statement saying the area of the circle is whatever that area is. We have to put these breaks in. Don't forget the breaks on the switch statement. That will let you run just that one case. Since for each menu item, we just want to run that one case, not everyone after that. So we'll put a break here. We'll do the same thing for case 2, which was a rectangle. Get the input. Display the output. 3, same thing for a triangle. And then we have a default. If they select something outside of the cases we gave them, we'll just display invalid selection. So we'll compile and run this. Let's just pick the first one, circle. Enter the radius. Let's put in a number so it calculates the area of the circle. Let's go ahead and pick 2. We'll put in 3 for the width, 4 for the length, calculates the area. We'll do triangle now, so 3, base, let's say 5, and the height of 10. So it calculates that. Let's go ahead and put an invalid input in, so 5, and we get a little bell there, warning. And then 4 will exit. And if you notice on the invalid input selection, we have invalid menu. If you remember, the backslash n is just the new line character. The backslash a is what caused that little alarm. It's the escape character for alarm. On some of the older computers, it's just a beep. On this one, it gave us a nice warning error, I guess Windows style. So this is just kind of a basic menu program. Just keeps repeating the menu and lets the user do that over and over.